Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day everyone. I hope you are fine today. This is teacher Amina Jamari Julkanain and ahlan wa sahlan. Welcome to our madrasa class in Arabic language for week 7. Today, learners, I am going to share to you about the antonym. In Arabic words, al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. Again, in Arabic, al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. And I want you to listen very carefully and try to define antonyms. I know you are now all ready to listen, so let us begin. Before we proceed, make sure you are ready and prepared with your materials needed for today's lesson, such as ball pen and capsule. And most especially, pay attention and focus to our discussion. Okay, take a look at the picture. What have you observed? Okay, the size of an apple. All right, what about the size of an apple? Okay, it is big and small. Okay, what do you call that words? All right, it is an antonyms. Now, we shall define the antonyms, or in Arabic word, kalimatul mutadad. Okay, that is kalimatul or kalimatu, al-kalimatu mutadaddatu. Okay. Now, let's define antonyms. What is antonyms? Okay. These are words that have opposite meanings. So, in Arabic, ma hiya al-kalimat al-mutadad. ما هي الكلمات المتضادة؟ هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. Okay. I repeat. هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. All right. Okay, I have here an example. Okay. Qaribun. Ba'idun. Qaribun, children, meaning it is near. So what is the opposite of near? Of course, it is far. In Arabic, far is ba'idun. Okay. Near, qaribun, far, ba'idun. So the opposite of qarib is ba'id. Okay, another example, like jadidun, qadimun. Jadid means new. Qadim means old. So the opposite of new is old. Like jadid, new, qadim, old. Okay, another example, yani misal, kabirun. Okay, kabirun, the opposite of kabir is sagirun. In English, big, and the opposite of big is small. All right, let's go to other example. Tawilun. The opposite of tawilun is qasirun. In English, tawil, tall. Qasir, short. Yay! Another example is kathirun. Kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. Again, kathirun, many. Qalilun, few. So the opposite of many is few. The opposite of kathirun is qalil. All right. Now, I want you to answer the self-assessment question. ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ ما هي الكلمة المتضادة؟ Okay, what are antonyms? Again, what are antonyms? Okay, learners, your answer is أيوة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. أيوة ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Okay, and then for the question number two, give the opposite meaning. Okay, of the following words. Jadidun. Hey, so what is the opposite meaning for jadidun? Aywa is what? Qadimun. Nice. Again, what is the opposite for kabirun? The opposite word for kabirun. Right, it is sagirun. Very good. Okay, now another one is ba'idun. So what is the opposite word for ba'idun? Okay, children, what is the opposite of words ba'idun? All right, is qaribun. Very good. Okay, let's practice what you have learned today by answering the following question. Okay, match the given words with its opposite and write the letter of the write the letter of the correct answer on the space provided for. Okay, number one, tawilun. Okay, number one, tawilun. Okay, what is your answer? What letter? All right, letter A, it's qasirun. Okay, let's go to number two. Jadidun. Again, jadidun. Okay, your answer is letter B. All right. It's qadimun. Okay. Let's go to number 3. Qaribun. Again, qaribun. Okay, your answer is ba'idun, letter. All right, letter C. Next, we go to number 4. Okay, number 4 is kabirun. Kabirun. Okay, your answer is letter. All right, letter D. It is sagirun. It is sagirun. Okay, next we go to number 5. Number 5 is kathirun. Again, kathirun. Okay, so your answer is letter E, qalilun. Okay, learner, we're going to remember the following. Okay, I want you to remember this, learners. Okay. الكلمة المتضادة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعناها أو لمعنى آخر. Again, الكلمة المتضادة هي كلمة معاكسة لمعنى آخر. Or in English, these are words that have opposite meanings. Let's see how much you have learned today by answering the following question. Directions. Match column A with column B by connecting it. Okay, let me read the words. Kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, wa qasirun. Again, in the column A, kabirun, qaribun, qadimun, kathirun, qasirun. Okay, now what is the match for kabirun? Okay, it's sagirun, right? You are correct. And then qaribun. Okay, ba'idun. Nice. How about qadimun? Okay, it's jadidun. Okay. Kathirun. Okay, the opposite for kathirun is qalilun. Okay, qasirun. Qasirun. Okay, the opposite is qawilun. Again, kabirun is big. The opposite of big is Small, it is sagirun. Qaribun or near. The opposite of qarib is ba'id, far. So, now kathirun, the opposite of kathir is what? Qalil, aywa. So, kathir, many, in qalil, few. Okay, qadimun. So, what is the opposite for qadimun? Or old. So, the opposite for the old is jadid, new. And for the opposite of short or qasir is tall, tawil in Arabic. All right. Okay, give the antonyms of the following Arabic words. Okay. Now, qadim. Okay. Qadimun. Aywa. Jadidun. Qaribun. Kathirun. Qalilun. Okay. Okay, qadimun, the opposite is jadidun. And then the jadidun, the opposite is qadimun. And qaribun, the opposite is, what is the opposite of qaribun? Aywa, ba'idun. Very good. Now, the opposite meaning for, or the opposite word for kathirun. Kathirun. I mean, yeah, kabirun. I'm sorry, kabirun. So, what is the opposite for kabirun? Aywa, qasir. Qasirun. All right. Next. Qalilun. What is the opposite of qalilun? Aywa, qalilun is kathirun. Aywa. Good job, learners. I know you did well on this activity. I hope I was able to make a clear discussion of today's lesson, and I hope that you will learn something from the lesson that I discussed to you. And I hope the discussions after this lesson was clear and you have learned something new today. So to conclude our lesson for today, once again, this is teacher Amina Jamari Chilkanain. Barakallahu fikum wa jazakumullahu khairan. Shukran. Keep safe, everyone.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A pleasant morning to my beloved pupils of grade 1. I am teacher Jahara Ayla Ja'alam, your Islamic values teacher for today. Kayfa halukum ya atfal, mauno-uno na kamu mga anak mo rin. I hope you are fine today. So our topic for today is about lesson 4, I make myself pure and clean. Okay, hadi pa kita makapagtagna sin pangadyanta, suway kamu sadya, dumungog marayaw, lingkod kamu marayaw, salta kaon nyo in capslet nyo, iban sin ballpen nyo, Asupaya hikasulat nyo in mga kalalagihan, hisulat. Okay, so for us to be guided, let me read the objectives of our lesson. Okay, number one, recite the Shahadatain or the testimony of faith. Basaha in dua pagsaksi. Number two, perform the proper steps of wudu or the ablution. Hinanga in aturan marayaw sin pag-air. And the third, recognize the importance of God Allah Ar-Razak, the everlasting sustainer in one's life. Lagwa in kabasaran sin Tuhan Allah, magdidihir rizki. Way katubtuban sin pagdihir niya rizki, hakabuhi sin hangkatao. So now let's proceed to understanding. So hukaban yung capsulet niyo. Aun kakitaan nyo rin doon to taud niya anak murid. Ingan niya Hisali, Hirafi, Iban, Yusuf. Okay, so let's listen to their conversation. Dungun na to in pagsambung laong sinto mag-classmate.
Yusuf, our teacher told us to always wash hands with soap and clean water. Yusuf, nag-iyan in mastal daran papaghugasun in lima sin sabun iban tubig.
Yes, we wash our hands every time we perform salah. We do that 5 times a day. Hoon, maghugas kita nyo lima na to sa kahaba magsambahayang.
That is wudu. We also do it before reading the Quran. Bihan in pagwudu, magwudu da isab sumamasa Quran. Okay, so amuyat to in pagsambung laong sinto mag classmate. So nangasubo, nagdihil sila idea. Yusuf, nagbaitain mastal niya, suway sila daran, papaghukasun sin, sabun, iban sin tuwig malano. Okay, damik yan, inagi isabi Yusuf, na bihat tura isab, apabila kita magsambahayang, na maghukas da isab kita sin, limata. So, inhantang niya, bang magsambahayang, suway kita mag-air. Okay, iwan bang magbasa isab Quran, suway resab kita mag-air. Okay. So, I keep myself pure and clean. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is delighted in me. So, daran ko paglanuan, iwan, susihun in baran ko. Supaya makuyag kako in Allahu ta'ala. So, in Allahu ta'ala, in kabayaan niya, katu subay kita, malano, masusi, ibansin, malano. So, baon sa rapat, subay kita daran mag-ail, maghugas, sin, pamarananta. Asupaya, malayo kita nyo din ha, mga sakit, luba na sakit bihaon yan, subay kita, daran maghugas sin limata. Okay, so halianta, kugdanan kita si mga COVID sakit yan, makawa din ha mga unuuday na mga lumi amin sakit di pagkakitaan. So suway kita mag ayad. So marikitan nyo pa self assessment question number 1. Okay, what are the ways of keeping your body clean? So unuin mga aturan hikalanu sinbaran. Okay, so mataud pa din ha mga aturan, hikalanu, sinbaran. Uno naman. So, bang nyo kaingatan? Okay. So, marayaw. So, hibay takukan niyo, bang uno naman in mga aturan, hikalanu, sinbaran. So, keeping our body clean, ikaisa, brushing our teeth 2 times a day. Subay ra kita magbrush, sinipon, makaduahang kaadlaw. Okay, number 2, taking a bath every day. Subay kita mamaygu adlaw-adlaw, supaya kita malano. Number 3, combing our hair with a clean comb. Manuglay sin suglay malano. Number 4, clipping or trimming our nails shorts. Manuptup sin kuko, bukon pasaran in kuko tayan maghawa. Kasuran siya sin karaw malumi mahinang ta sakit. So subay siya tuptupan. Ikalima, washing our hands before each meal. So hugasan in lima hadi pa kumaon atawa before and after eating. Subay kita maghugas sin lima ta hadi pa kita makakaon iban man kita isab maubos na kumaon subay ra isab kita humugasin lima ta hasupaya kita malano. Okay, so nakakamu pangajian dito mga bata. Alhamdulillah. Okay, biyaon pangajiun ta in mga steps when performing wudu. Okay, dungog ka mo marayaw ini in aturan si pag-ambil wudu. Hasupaya kita makasambahayang, subay kita magwudu na amuna. Sabab in wudu, amu ini in hinang, hadi pa kita maka tindog sin sambahayang. Okay, hika isa, make niya or the intention to perform wudu. So, magniat bang tumagna na mag-ail. Okay, niyatun muna, halom simpangatayan mo, in ikaw yaon mag-ail, karna in ikaw sumambahayang. Okay, number 2. Recite Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhati niya, masa sinlapal Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Inhikatu, wash your hands. Humugas sin 25 makatu. Ikaupat, rinse your mouth. Gumguman in simud makatu. Inikalima, sniff water then blow it out of your nose 3 times. Humanggit tubig hailong. Ampa mo hisunga makatupag balikan. So inhikal unum, wash your face. Hugasan in bayho makatu. Okay, so in paghugas na sin bayho, amin bayho tayan sa suko sin wala tiwuan sin buhok, doon haunahan, katanyan, part yan sin bayho ta. So, hukasan in bayhu makatu. Ikapito, wash your arms up to your elbows. Humugas, inbuktun tubtub pasiku. Makauna intuu ang papalawa. Pagbalikan, makatu. Biarasin, hinang mo hakaibanan. Okay, hati niya, humugas kita sinbuktun. Tubtub pasiko, intuo makatu muhugasan. Pag-ubos, ang paisa, matunisab ko palawa, makatu isab hugasan. Ikawalo, with your head, sumapusin u makatu. Ikasyam, with your ears inside and out. Sapuhun intay nga palawong pahuwa, makatu. Okay. And then, ikahangpu, wash your feet. Hugasan in siki, tub-tub, pabuku-buku. Makauna in tuu, ampa, palawa, makatu. So, hugasan mo in siki mo, tuu, makatu. Pag-ubos, ampa, isabkaw, matunpa. Siki mo, dapit palawa, makatu, isabin paghugas mo. Tub-tub pa, buku-buku, bang maghugas. Hasupaya lumano maigin lumi. Maubos man in mga hinangyat to, ang panakita, mang duaa. Okay, so isayang tayong dua lima tabiahan, mang duaa kita, i-recite ta, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashadu anna muhammadan rasulallah. So amu ini in lapal, basa hunta. So masa sinlapal, ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadan rasulallah. So amuyat to. Okay. So, nakaingat na kamo bang biyariin in pag-air? Mura-murahan, mag-anad kamo, isurein kanyo in, nakapangadji haadlaw ini. So, mari kita nyo pa self-assessment question. Question number 2. So, pangasubo. So, what are the steps in performing wudu? So, uno in mga aturan sin pag-ambil air. Okay, so balikan ta ha, supaya katumtuman. So, magniat kita bang tumagna na in mag-air. Ikarua, masa sinlapal bismillah. Inhika tu humugas, sin dua, lima makatu. Pag-ubos, gumguman in simod, makatu. Ubus, humanggit, sintubig, hailong, ampamuhisunga, makatu, pagbalikan. Inhika lima, inhika unum isab, hukasan, inbayhu, makatu. Okay, hinika pito, humuras, sinbuktun, tubtub pa, siku. Okay, makauna, intu, ampapalawa, pagbalikan, makatu. Ikawalo sumapusin o makatu. Inikasiyam, sapuhon intay nga palaumpakuwa makatu. Ubos inikahangpu, hugasan insiki tubtub pabuku-buku, makauna intuo ang papalawa makatu. Sarta bang naubos na in mga steps yato na ang panakita mag-recite sin babasahan halapal ashadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashadu anna muhammadar rasulallah. So dain hatu sampul na na in pag ayil or in pag ambil wudu ta. Okay, so mari kita niyo aunde indi pagnganan, let's practice. Okay, so kaun yung capslet niyo iban sin ballpen niyo. Jawaban tayin mga pangasubo ini. So, basahon ko in directions, dungog ka mo. Ensilker the picture that shows good habit. Hatin niya, ligungi in patta amuin magpakita adat marayaw. Okay, so on din dun patta-patta ha-capslate niyo. Patta number 1, bata-bata. Eating while walking. Hatin niya, magkaunsalta miyamanaw. Okay, so inligungan mo amin marayaw in habit, marayaw in adat, ha? Magpakita sin pangadatan marayaw. Ikarua, washing the fruits before eating it. Ukasan in bungang kahoy nasung kumaon. Atin niya bang ang mga bungang kahoy, biyan na sin mga mangga, apple, ununa. Ukasan muna siya muna ang pamukaunon. Ikatu, throwing banana peel on the ground. Ubus kimaun saing in batabatayaon, biugit na paisaing. Hatin niya, magbugit paisaing halantay. Marayaw ba yan o mangi? Okay. Next picture, buying street foods without cover. Magbi makaunharan, wairoon saob or wailukub niya. Pagkaw, marayaw ba yan? Okay, on yan waktu in langaw, maglupad-lupad na doon. Okay, next. Cleaning the street, maglano sindan. At wala labayan sin kita, lanuan. Okay. And last, combing the hair, magsuklay buhok. Okay, so how nurunin mga kakahinang, ikarayaw sin baran na to. Okay, so naubos na kamo nag-answer. Okay, so mari kita nyo pa, sadya kamo pa lesson 5. Okay, marayaw in pangadjian din di makakatud kita, pangadjian marayaw. So in topic niya ri, what are you waiting for? Hatin niya, uno pa in tagaran mo? So in title niya, the ants. Okay, so basahon ko dungog kamo marayaw. One day, a lazy man saw 100 of ants. Each ant carries food. Hati niya, in ants yaon, mga tausog, in sanam. Okay, nakita na kamo sanam. Okay. Hambok adlaw, nakita in usog, lisuan. Yato san sanam. Tiap-tiap hambok din kanila nagdara kakaon. So they are helping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the hall. So magtulong tabang in pakanya-kanya hapagdasing kakaon malaggo. In tubtuban, naranila in pagkaon palomsin lungag. Okay, so aun pa nga subo. What is the moral lesson in the story? So uno in makawa pangadian hakisa sin sanam. Okay. Very good. Atin ya in mga sanam ini, in sila ini matibot, iwan matuyo, no? Iwan in sila magtabang-tiabangi. Magtabang-tabang sila, di sila magpasad. Okay, so biaturay sabi pangadatan sin kita marayaw, subay magtabang-tabang, iwan di sila magpikil sin luog nila. So hard work, they work hard. Okay, so that they can reap the benefits tomorrow. So magtaw sila pagkaon nila supaya hasusungon aun makawa mahampit nila. Okay. So in virtues of hard work and planning for the future. So in moral lesson amoy atin makata. So aun sila pagtabang-tabang iban matibot sila. Okay. So mari kita pa let's practice. Okay, answeran nyo isab ini. Okay, I will read the directions. Okay, complete each sentence. Underline the correct word inside the parenthesis. Okay, hati niya, jukupa in kaptangan, good listen, in bunal, halom sin, baugan. Okay, basahon ko, underline na nyo sa dya, in pagpian nyo dua word. Okay, one day, a lazy lad, man sat under the tree. He saw hundreds of rats or ants. They were all organized and running, moving. Each ant carries food, stone. They are helping, stepping each other in carrying big food. Finally, they carried the food into the mall hall. Okay, so tausog niya. Hambok adlaw in lisuan, subol. Magpi ka mo inan sa lisuan ka or subol. Usog, naglilingkod hasom kahoy. Nakita siya giyatusan mga ambaw atawa sanam. So, unin answer niyo. Ambaw yung kita niya or sanam. In sila katan, nagtutukot yukuhi. Iban, dimaragan, himihibal. Unagunin sanam, dimaragan or himihibal. Okay, pagpian yung answer yan. So, tiap-tiap sanam, nagdara, kakaun, bato. Hey, unin diarasin sanam, kakaun ataw bato. So, in sila, nagtulong, tabang, nagmamahil. Okay, hapagdas, impagkaun, maaslag. Ha, kahinapusan, naranila, impagkaun, palaom, lungag or taylalat. Okay, so pinakamuang jawab niyo. Okay, so basta huntayin niya supaya di takalupahan. As a Muslim, we have to affirm the ashadatain. Ashadu an la ilaha illallah. I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. Wa ashadu anna Muhammad is his messenger. In Muslim, subay siya mga hagad hadua saksi. Magsaksi ako inway Tuhan mapatut pagtag-ipunan malengkan Allah. Iban magsaksi ako in Muhammad daaksin Allah. So we should apply the values of cleanliness and personal hygiene. Subay tahinangun in pangadatan marayaw biyanasin maglano ibansin pagsusisin ginhawabaran. Okay, we have to be hard working like the ants. Subay kita matibot biasin sanam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a Razzaq, the everlasting sustainer. In Allah, siya in magdidirijiki, di magbugtuin dirihilan niya. Okay, so let's see how much you have learned today. Kita unta kuno bang hariin na in kya hatihan yung adlaw ini. So jawaban niyo in mga pangasubo ha assessment. Okay, so direction number one, the following steps of wudu are not in the correct number or order, which should come first. So number them from 1 to 11. Write the number inside the small box. So wala na susun-susun in aturan sin pag-ayil, pagsunua. Umbuli day na hambuok pahangpo tagisa. Sulatan in umbul halom sin tuong. So amo na yan in mga steps in wudu, butangan nyo siya number 1 hang up to pa 11. Okay. So hikaruwa exercise niyo, name each part of the picture, then color it. So aun din dun araw timudlo ha mga patta yan. So ngani injinisan sin patta pagubos ang pamu warna i. Way na bida warna in hibutang mo. Okay. So dito na timubtub in pangajian ta. Alhamdulillah muramurahan makaka kamu pangajian din kamu adlaw ini. Wabillahi taufik wal hidayah. This is Teacher Jahara saying wa ilal lika. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Assalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Wa ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Marayawat law kan yung katan dimurungog ha programa na to. Di hakasusuban na to a registration di triple X. Hadlaw ini, yari na isab, ika ni tuantaha.
Bani teacher niyo dayang.
Nagbalik para pangadjaan na to. Impangadjaan na to hadlaw ini, amunain pagtaat parwa maas. Halialihantan niyo na ahang karay para hapatumtum ini. Stay tuned.
أشرقت نفسي بنور من فؤادي حينما رددت يا رب العباد وانتشت روحي وصار الدمع يجري يا إله.
الحمد لله يا ريني سبك منك بليك إبان سينك مويان دمس مسي دمرونغوغ kaputin niyo, iwan ukaban niyo ing capslet niyo, magdungan-dungan ta niyo, basahon, suy-suy ini.
It was Saturday morning. Fatima and Ummi are very busy cleaning their house and backyard. This is a time for helping their parents. Omar is busy reading his book. His father said, "My son, please help Ummi clean our backyard." Omar replied, "Abi, I still have many things to study. Our ustad assigned me to read my kitab." His father said, "But today is Saturday. You still have time to do your assignment. Didn't your ustad teach you about obedience to parents? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards those who obey their parents." Omar answered, "Sorry, Abi. Yes, our ustads taught us to obey our parents. Allah ta'ala favors children who are obedient to their parents. I will just fix my things, then I will help Ummi clean the backyard." "Thank you, my son," his father replied. "He will go to mall with Fatima and Ummi after you're done cleaning."
May laatin adlaw sabto, naglano bay iwan halaman ni Fatima kaina niya. Amuin wakto tumabang hamaas niya. nagbawas sa kitab ya umap agi hi ama niya uto tabangi hi ina mo maglano alaman hatay kudpay insambong hi umar kanama niya ama yari pa ako nangangadji aun kitab piyabas sa kamu sinustaz na mo agisin ama at law ini sabto aun pawaktu mo huminang sinhinang tuhon kay mo mahi wala kau hinduan sinustaz tungod pagta at pamaas gandahan sin Allahu Ta'ala bang hisisyo imagta at parwa maas niya. Sambung hi Omar, maaf ama, hinduan kami sinustaz na mo, magtaat pamaas. Kaulungan kau sinallahu ta'ala. Inbata nagtaat pamaas niya, mumusun ko sadya im mga kitab ko. Ampa ako madto, tumabang kan ina maglano sinhalaman hatay ko. Magsukol anak, sambung sin ama niya kanya. Madto kita niyo patinda hi Fatima iban hi ina mo pag-uhus niyo maglano. Halihalihan tanyo na hangkaray ayaw ko mag-ig di high station tanyo di triple X magbalik da kami. Stay tuned. Alhamdulillah, yarinay sab kita nung nagbalik, damikyanin ka mo masimasi, dimurungog, haprograma tanyo. Bihaon, lumatun kita nyo, pa self-assessment question. Number one,
what is obedience?
Uno, inhati simpagtaat. Number two,
what are the deeds showing obedience to parents?
Uno naman in hinang marayaw, hipagmarayaw ta parwa maasta. Tumtumun ta niyo, ayaw ta niyo kalupahan. Bunal tuo din Allahu Ta'ala, tungbasan niya in bata atawa anak, nagtaat parwa maas niya. Pasal impagtaat parwa maas, lawang papagtaat pa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan suway tanyo di pahil-pahilon impagtaat ataw pagmarayaw tanyo parwa maas tanyo sabab bang kita nyo nagmarayaw parwa maas biada kita nakapagmarayaw fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Hangkan na imbata suway siya mapanday pakuyahun niya indwa maas niya hasupaya in Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala kumuyag kaniya sabab in kuyag sin Allahu Ta'ala doon tanyo kabakan hakuyag sin duwa maas tanyo iban imbungsi atawa astul sin Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala doon tanyo kabakan habungsi iban astul sin duwa maas tanyo bihaon sulayan tanyo bang uno in nakawa tanyo pangadjian haadlaw ini hatungod simpagtaat parwa maas kawa kamu katas niyo iwan simpensil niyo sulatan niyo hakatas niyo bunnal bang ingkabtangan ini imamo sulatan niyo hakatas niyo bukon bang ingkabtangan ini wala imamo. Number one,
obedience to parents is a way of obedience to Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Impagtaat pamaas, lawang siya papagtaat pa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Number two,
a child should follow all orders of his her parents.
In bata, suway magad hapamintoro si maas niya. Number three,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards a child for obeying his her parents.
Tungbasan sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bata nagtataat pamaas. Number 4.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punishes a child for not obeying his her parents.
Siksaun sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in bata di magtaat pamaas. Number 5.
Obey your parents next to your friends.
Magtaat na pamaas ang papakabagayan. Mahuli, mamaid na kami kaniyo, ini hika ni tuantaha, Iban.
Teacher Dayang.
Habaliwasan Central School, Sped Center, MEP Teacher, COS. Salam kasila sa kaniyo katan. Wa ilan lika.
Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A blessed day to you, my beloved learners. How are you today? I hope you're doing well. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Welcome to Arabic Language, Grade 6, Week 7 and 8. This is Teacher Nafisa H. Ainadi, your teacher for today. Before we start our lesson, make sure you are in a comfortable place. Get your capsule, ball pen, paper, and notebook for you to jot down important matters during discussions. Children, listen carefully and attentively. Try to comprehend our lesson for today. Okay, children, are you ready? So let's begin. Our topic for today is about as-sifatu. Meaning of as-sifatu is adjective. For us to be guided in today's lesson, our objectives are: number 1, give the meaning of adjective. Number 2, identify the adjective in a sentence. To start with, let us first define as-sifatu or the adjective. As-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan, kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. It means that the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describes it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. If the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children, did you understand? Let's continue.
Okay, let's read a paragraph using adjectives. The title of paragraph is Al-Kitabu, meaning the book. Al-Kitabu al-Mufidu, Sadiqun Nafi'un. والذي يقرأ الكتاب يعرف شيئا كثيرا من الحياة. The useful book is a valuable friend. Whoever reads a book knows many things in this life and does not get bored. الكتاب جليس لا يمل جليسا والكتاب وعاء مملوء علما وهو ناطق ينطق عن الأحياء ويتحدث عن الموتى. The book is a container that full of knowledge and wisdom. It tells the life of an individual and the story of his death. والقرآن الكريم خير الكتب أنزله الله ليهدي به الناس إلى الصراط المستقيم. And the Holy Quran is the best book that Allah sent to guide mankind. Okay, children, are you still with me? The adjective used in this paragraph are Al-Mufidu. It means useful. Next, Nafi'un, valuable. Next adjective, Kathiran, many. Another adjective used is Mamlu'un, full. And the last adjective we got from the paragraph is Al-Mustaqim, guide. Now, children, let's answer this self-assessment question. Okay, what is adjective? Ma ma'na as-sifa? Okay, we will answer. The meaning of as-sifatu is as-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi lituwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan, kanat as-sifatu ma'rifatan. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. But if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, let's practice what we have learned today. Directions. Tawjihun. ضع خطا تحت الصفة في الجمل الآتية. Underline the adjective in the following sentences. Number one sentence. هذه خريطة نافعة. Okay, where is the adjective in this sentence, children? Okay, let's answer. The answer is نافعة. Okay, are you done? Number two. الرجل المسلم meaning the man is Muslim. So where is the sifa in this sentence? Okay, the answer is المسلم. Number three. القميص الصفراء جديد. Meaning, the yellow shirt is new. Okay, where is the asifa in this sentence? Okay, the answer is As-safra'u. Okay, class, did you get it? I hope so. Now, let's remember these key points. As-sifatu ta'ti ba'da al-ismi litwaddihahu. Wa idha kana al-mawsufu ma'rifatan كانت الصفة معرفة. إذا كان الموصوف نكرة كانت الصفة نكرة. Meaning, the adjective comes after the noun to clarify or describe it. If the adjective is common noun, the word after it should also be common noun. And if the adjective is proper noun, the word after it should also be proper noun. Okay, children, clear? Now, let's have you learned today? Answer the self or assessment. Directions. Tawjihun. Daqqan tahta sifati في الجمل الآتية. Number one. البيت الكبير جميل. Again, البيت الكبير جميل. It means that the big house is beautiful. Just underline the adjective. Number two, الشجرة الخضراء كثيرة الثمار. Again, الشجرة الخضراء كثيرة الثمار. Meaning, the green tree have many fruits. Number three, الطالب الذكي قد نجح في الامتحان. Meaning, the bright student pass the examination. Okay, number 4. Al-mudarrisu al-mahiru sharaha ad-darsa. Again, al-mudarrisu al-mahiru sharaha ad-darsa. Meaning, the teacher or the expert teacher explained the lesson. And number 5. At-tabibu as-satiru yu'alijul marida. Meaning, the expert doctor is giving medicine to the patient. Okay, children, that's all for today. It's time for me to say bye now. I hope that you understand well and learned something new. Keep on studying and reading ahead of time for you to comprehend well the lesson taught. Again, this is Teacher Napisa H. Ainadi saying, Wadaan, ilan niko.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah, assalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. Wa ba'd, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Marayaw adlaw kaniukatan, dimurungog ha programa na to, di ha kasusuban na to radio station, di triple X. Haadlaw ini, yari na isab hika ni Tuan Taha
ni Teacher Dayang
nagbalik para hapangadjian na to. In pangadjian na to, haadlaw ini, amunain, why do Muslim pray? Maita in Muslim suway magsambahayang. Halialihanta na ang karay para hapatumtum ini. Stay tuned. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. Yari na isab kami nagbalik. Ibansin kamu yanda masimasi dimurungog. Kaputin niyo, iban ukaban niyo, encapsulate niyo. Magdungan-dungan kita niyo, basahon impangadjian ini. Impangadjian taniyo haadlaw ini, why do Muslim pray? Maita in Muslim suway magsambahayang. Basahon na to na aha English, hisalin na to pabahasa sinog.
Performing Salah. Allahu Ta'ala orders all Muslim to pray 5 times a day. We call this prayer Salah. It is the second pillar of Islam. Praying 5 times a day is the first step to worship Allahu Ta'ala. It is the key to enter paradise. When a Muslim prays, he talks to his Creator, Allahu Ta'ala.
In Allahu Ta'ala, nang daaki pakatan Muslim, in suway magsambahayang 5 waktu hatiap-tiap adlaw. In tawag ha ibadat ini, amuna in sala, atawakan sambahayang. Siana in hikarwa rukun, deng ha mga rukun sin Islam lima. Impagsambahayang lima waktu, amunay ni impanagnaan ibadat pa Allahu subhanahu wa ta'ala, sarta siya kunsi siya sinsulga. Bangin Muslim magsambahayang, in siya di man nagbisara iban sin nagpapanjari kanya Allahu ta'ala. Bihaon lumatun kita niyo pa self-assessment question. Number one,
what are the five obligatory prayers?
Uno-uno naman in sambahayang lima waktu.
Number two, what is the importance of prayer?
Uno in kahalgaan sin pagsambahayang lima waktu.
Prayers. Salah is part of Islam. Prayer have five times obligatory prayers. These are Fajr, Dhuhr, Asar, Maghrib, and Isha. It is important to do these obligatory prayers because it is commanded by our God, Allah Ta'ala, to observe our prayers daily, especially to those Muslim who are obliged to do it. When you do prayer, you gain reward from Allah Ta'ala. But when you forbid in performing it, you will be punished in the hereafter. So, it is important for a Muslim to perform prayer.
In sambahayang hambuok siya deng harukun sin Islam. In sambahayang aun siya lima waktu, wajib subay tunayun. Amunain, Fajar, Zuhur, Asar, Maghrib, Iban Isha. In sambahayang lima waktu, mahal ka siya subay hinangun. Pasal in sambahayang ini, daakan sinallahu ta'ala. In subay siya hitunay makalima hatiap-tiap adlaw. Labi awla ha mga naggugulal Muslim. Bangkaw timunay sinsambahayang madawhat mo intungbas deng ha Allahu Ta'ala. Sa bang mutinggalan impagtunay kaniya, siksaon kau sin Allahu Ta'ala ha adlaw mahuli. Hasawabiyad to, mahal ka ha Muslim in subay siya tumunay sinsambahayang lima waktu. Hali-alihan tanyo na karay, ayaw ko mag-ig, iban ay ko magpinda tiyon. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin, yari na isab kita niyo nagbalik. Iwan sing kamu yanda masimasi di murungog ha registration kasusuban taniyo di triple X. Alhamdulillah, nakakawa kita niyo pangadjian hatungod sing pagsambahayang lima waktu. Bihaon tumtumuntan niyo.
Performing salah means obedience to Allah Ta'ala. When we perform salah, it makes a person avoid doing wrong things and make him remember Allah all the times. Every time he pray, and it can be make one use.
Impagtunay sin sambahayang ini, pagtaat, iban pag-ibadat fa Allah Ta'ala. Bangkita timunay sin sambahayang in ini mangdahi kato humalli deng ha mga hinang mangi. Iban manumtum kaniya fa Allahu Ta'ala. Hakatan waktu. Iban ha waktu siya magsambahayang mahinang siya hambuok deng ha mga nagmamabuga fa Allahu Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Halyato nakawatan yu resab pangajian ing kahalgaan simpagsambahayang tungbas dirihilan deng Allah Ta'ala. Demikian in mamahil pahil atau meninggalkan niya aunday sab siksa kaniya haadlaw kanagana. Deng hamanga kahalgaan simpagsambahayang suway makalipaga katu tanyo in uno-uno hinang tanyo sabab amunaun impanagnaan ibadat asubuhon katu tanyo haadlaw kiyama pasar simpagsambahayang. Nabang siya dimayaw, dimayaw ingkatan kakahinang tanyo. Sagawa bang insambahayang kimangi besim pagpahil-pahil atawa pagtinggal tanyo, magadda isab kumangi ingkatan kakahinang tanyo. Halialihan tanyo na ang karai, ayoko mag-ig, stay tuned. Sulay-sulayan tanyo na ah, bang uno impangadjian na kawa tanyo haadlaw ini. Kawaan niyo, ingkatas niyo, iban pensil niyo, yari ang mga pangasuwo. Sulatan niyo, bunal, bang imbitsara imamo. Iban sulatan niyo, bukon, bang imbitsara wala imamo.
Number one, all people should perform salah.
Katan tao suway magtunay sin sambahayang.
Number two, salah is a part of Islam.
In sambahayang, bahagian siya sin Islam.
Number three, salah makes a person avoid doing wrong things.
In sambahayang, mangdahi hatao humalli deng hahinang mangi.
Number four, performing salah means obedience to Allah Ta'ala.
In pagtunay sin sambahayang ini, pagtaat iwan pag-ibadat fa Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala.
Number five, salah has one obligatory prayer only.
In sambahayang, aun siya hambuok wajib fardu. Insha'Allah, next week, dugaing nasab pangadjian immakawatan niyo. Mura-murahan, papagbarakatun sinallahu ta'ala im mga nakawa na to pangadjian haadlaw ini iwan haadlaw susungon mahuli mamaid na kami kaniyo ini hika ni tuantaha
Vani Teacher Dayang
Dainha Baliwasan Central School SPED Center MEP Teacher COS Salam kasila sa kaniyo katan
wa ilal liqa. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.
Fuerza, este el RPND Triple X, Radio Ronda Zamboanga.
This is Radio Philippines Network, E Triple X Zamboanga, E Triple X Zamboanga.